clear that how we behave and how we feel depends a lot on what we eat and what we have eaten. But really, how that works at the mechanistic level, how nutrients act on neurons and the brain, is something we don't really understand at all. So what we would like to understand is, how do now specific nutrients affect how neurons work? And then also, what is the contribution of gut microbes, so these small bacteria we and all organisms have in their gut, in making these decisions? And this is based on a discovery we have done. And so the way we have chosen to do that in the laboratory, and there's a long history of 100 years of people have done that, is by using the insect, Drosophila melanogaster, the small fruit fly. And the reason we use the fly is because it is genetically and cellularly very similar to all other organisms, including humans. But obviously, we can do many more experiments and different types of experiments that we could never do in other systems. And we can do many more experiments, that there are two bacteria in the gut of the fly which tell the brain to eat or not to eat proteins. And so the way we have done that is in two ways. First, we have changed the chemicals which the bacteria use to talk to each other. And then we did behavior. So we filmed flies eating and choosing between protein and sugar to see if now we can change this decision. The other thing we have done is we have used a new type of microscopy, which we have developed in the lab, to look at how neurons fire when the fly is eating, having or not having bacteria. And that has allowed us to understand how nutrients and bacteria change the way neurons talk to each other and how that then changes the behavior of the animal. And this opens a completely new way to actually look at how the brain reacts and works in different nutrient states, and how that at the end influences the decisions animals have to do, including humans. But I think in general, what we don't understand is how nutrients, how nutrition, how what we eat influences in general the probability of getting certain diseases or protects us from certain diseases. And I think that's really one of the big open questions, right? How is nutrition at the end enabling us to be more resistant towards all kinds of other pathologies? And that's, I think, one of the things where our research could really push the boundary of our knowledge. I think we are entering into a time when human well-being is not only shaped by diseases, but also by the negative impact of human civilization on our ecosystems. So understanding how insects react to nutrients and then being able to influence that might be really vital for human well-being in the next decades when we enter a time of climate change. So it's about understanding better animals, understanding better humans, but also understanding animals in a time of climate change, and then insects there have a big role to play.